All America, we're gonna be getting, we're getting Taste of Japan. We're getting, Cultist bringing out the Icies versus, Cheeks pulling out Lucina.
Okay, so interesting. Cheeks not going Cloud today, realizing my character is, the worst Lucina.
Really?
I have an up out of shield. So he's playing Lucina.
that's
what I'm gathering. I don't know if that's his actual thought process, but...
Do you know about the Cheeks Lucina? Is this something that he's brought out before? Is this something he is planning on going all day today?
I have never heard a word of it, and we were just on commentary about it before. Maybe it's like an Icy's-specific thing. Maybe it's just round one, round two kind of stuff before he needs to bust out up the out of shield, but we'll see.
Possibly. I know he was complaining about it on Twitter. Just, you know, a lot of the Cloud mains getting frustrated with the linear play of Cloud now that he has so many options removed from him. But I mean, Lucina character plays fairly similarly, though definitely not lacking in options or the tier list quality. I mean, Lucina is an incredibly strong character. So, fantastic down smash there. I don't even know how he found that. And the up B though to end that stock, and just like that, Cheeks takes the first stock in this. Cultist though keeping it mad close.
Yeah, for sure. I mean,
not quite gonna take it though. Good DI.
Yeah, no, Cheeks is playing really, really well right now. Cultist, again, still able to keep it even. Wow, that would have been a big up smash. Absolutely.
Yeah, it's something I feel like we're going to be seeing a lot of, and we've already seen a good amount of it, is Cultist is a player who really likes to throw out these icy aerials that are normally extremely safe. But one of the things about Lucina is that she has a longer stick than the ice climbers, and when you're whiffing aerials against a longer stick, odds are your longer stick is going to get beat out. I mean, your shorter stick. So yeah. I think we're going to be seeing a lot of Cultist. I think the one thing he's going to have to adapt to is being a little bit more patient and not whiffing so many aerials, because that's something that Cheeks, I mean, Lucina even just in general, is going to eat up.
Yeah, just absolutely dominate when it comes to that. But.
Yeah, his aggressive approaches, though, like I was talking about, just getting punished and stuffed out entirely. Cultist now, I mean, whereas it wasn't an even game, couldn't be further from the truth, though. 140%, and that is
the death. The pummel killed him!
He buffered a roll. He tried to, it's like got the air dodge. Unfortunate from Cultist, though, but, I mean, Icy's, their damage output is wild. I mean, look at that. One neutral win, and he's already at 88.
Cultist got wobbled. Cultist got pummeled to death. Welcome to Melee.
Oh my gosh.
No, wait, I don't want to
go. Don't go back. The ballsy parry. No up tilt punish, though. No up tilt up air. Gonna find it. Good forward air jab. Mark from Cheeks to drop his shield. It's not a true shield break, but if he catches you holding, he will pop that bubble.
Absolutely. Side B from behind once again. We saw that earlier in the forward air, him both characters there.
Really cute, reminiscent of those of the cross slash cover ups. And now we're gonna be seeing Cheeks go up two stocks. Oh, good stuff from Cheeks though. The Lucina looking kind of fresh.
Yeah, no, Lucina's kind of clean. Cheeks been playing a sword character for so long, and like a lot of the time, people will compare, like, if you played a zoner for a couple years, you can probably play the other ones well enough. The same thing with sword characters. I mean, Cloud isn't a Fire Emblem character who is typically called just the Swordies plus Cloud and like Shulk, but he played Cloud for so long that at some point,
if you have a sword,
you know how to use it.
I mean, yeah, it's definitely one. I mean, it's one of those things that I think is a reason people complain about a lot of sword characters being added, is because even though there are a lot of different mechanics in the way they'll add these characters, fundamentally they're pretty much the same. You're fighting with a big stick. You're going to be spacing. You're going to be whiff punishing. It's just going to be a lot of that. And sometimes you can play aggressive. I mean, we're going to be seeing that from Cheeks now that he's switched over to Krom.
We see Krom going in. Krom is actually really, really sick as a character. I think Cheeks.
Ooh, nice break with the Blizzard.
Yeah.
Nice up tilt. What's he going to find off it? No tech chase, though. Could have been huge.
That down tilt.
I like the roll behind.
Yeah.
Blizzwall going to get punished out with the getup attack. It's something Cultist is going to have to look out for. That getup attack is going to have a lot of those.
Goodbye.
And that forward smash is going to interrupt his life.
Yeah, so that side B is something that Cultist has been using way too high above ledge for the last whole game. So Cheeks is like, I'm going to go to a character where punishing that is even better.
You thought my punishes were good before.
Yeah.
Oh.
If you thought Lucina F-Smash was neat, look at Krom's F-Smash.
If you thought her F-Smash was wild, wait till Krom does it.
That was kind of sick.
That was
super cool.
Beautiful, decent combo, though.
Oh,
Cheeks
no!
off stage. Not quite going to find it, though. Good stuff from Cheeks, though, holding in to get the pop from the Blizzard, so he's not going to get edgeguarded. And now Cultist in a bad spot, and the forward smash going to take it at 43%. Unbelievable. Now Cultist going down three stocks to one. This is looking grim. Good up smash, though.
Trying to keep him in the game. He's still a whole stock down. He has to play really, really well from here on out, especially not wanting to lose that Nana.
I mean, this is something Ice Climbers, I mean, if you've ever opened Twitter, you know that Ice Climbers can dish out the damage like no other. So this is possible, but it definitely balls in Cultist's court here. He has to make a big play if he wants to bring this comeback.
And we've seen ESAMS for the last whole week has just been nothing but ICY's play. And so you can tell that, you know, zero to deaths are definitely a thing for this character if no other character has one.
Absolutely. I mean, a lot of it's impractical, but there's a lot that is practical, and that's the scary stuff. But right now, I mean, Colt is doing a really good job. I mean, he's kind of going, you know, tip for tap here, which is what you don't really want to see. 117% though on Cheeks. He has a small lead. Can he get the conversion? Good stuff. 98% on him though. I mean, this is well within Krom's range. I mean, 1-4 till that ledge, and that's it. You already see Cheeks looking out for it, though.
Ooh.
I like the attempt on the punish, though. Ooh, big damage, though. 0-49, and just like... Oh, 4 tilt gonna take out Nana, but not Popo. That's definitely it. He uses his double jump, and that's it.
Oh, he almost... Koda's went for the handshake, but Cheeks did the up being almost caught himself game number 2. That would've been fine to see as game 3.
Oh my gosh.
That would have been something.
That would have been wild, but not definitely a storyline we're not going to get to crack open here.
Not quite.
But, I mean, Cheeks going to take it 2-0. Pretty commanding fashion, honestly. I think that's probably one of those matchups that's just kind of rough for ICYs. Their neutral is not amazing, and especially when you're playing against a character who basically does what you do better in every way, in the essence of, like, having a disjoint, you're just going to find a lot of difficulty ever getting your disjoint to work because their stick is longer than yours, and that's just how it is.
Absolutely. And we are talking about how ICYs can, in theory, bring back a 2-stock to 1-stock deficit.
Oh, yeah, I mean...
But at the same time, getting those crazy zero to deaths in training mode is difficult. Getting it on CPUs is harder. Getting it in tournament, on stream, against Cheeks is super, super hard.
Yeah,
because you have turning nerves, stream nerves, and you're playing against Cheeks, who's on the PR and really, really, really good for, like, the last year and a half across 2 different games.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, Cultist doesn't take me as the man to kind of get shaken up too much on stream, but, I mean, regardless, the fact remains, whether or not you're nervous or not, I mean, getting yourself to actually perform, not only get the opening for a crazy ICY's combo, but to actually perform the entirety of it, extremely, extremely difficult. So